For me personally, it's what I always wanted to do. I was a preschool teacher before, and so I actually worked with the two-year-old preschool class. It wasn't even really preschool, but 2 to 3 year olds, and I loved it. And I was passionate about helping little ones fix those problems early so that they can have really bright futures. And the parents would have the skills to work with them at home and encourage language development as it goes on. So for me, it's what I always wanted to do. What is it like though now that I'm actually doing it? So I felt like I was really prepared with the preschool experience. So I recommend that you get some experience beyond just like speech related, just experience working with kids. So you understand like the tantrums and the body training and the constant nose wiping and just like things like that. And you get desensitized to those kinds of things because they can be kind of a lot. For me, early intervention is great. Driving to families' homes can be like a really cool thing in that I get a break. Not all intervention, early intervention is in home. Sometimes at a clinic or a hospital, whatever. But for me, I do the in-home. So that means I drive to like 5 to 6 families' homes a day and do 5 to 6 hours of individual speech therapy. And I like the drive because it gives me a little break in between. And then coming into a family's home, first time, I can be a little nervous. It's a new environment and they're a little nervous. But after a while, I'm like, wow, this is like another home for me. Hey guys, what's going on? And it's really great because you develop a closer relationship. You are in their home. You see all the family members, grandma and grandpa, and you're playing in their backyard. And all of those things are just like really neat for creating a nice bond and doing meaningful therapy in the child's everyday environment. So it's really great. Yeah, it can be really frustrating sometimes because toddlers are toddlers and they're gonna cry, and sometimes they're gonna cry the whole time and there's nothing you can do about it. I'm really desensitized to it at this point, and I have a lot of really great strategies for dealing with things like that. And you can watch those videos. I'll put links to how to decrease tantrums, how to decrease aggressive behavior, etc. And it's really important that I teach the parents I work with how to do these techniques as well, so that it's not just me one time a week working with the child in this way. So I've seen really great improvements. I do keep track of the number of tantrums the child has and how long they last and how long their attention is, because I want to make sure that we're making progress in those ways too. And it's great to show a parent, hey, remember in the beginning we had 10 tantrums in one session? Now we're having one tantrum in one session. So otherwise, earlier intervention is great because I don't have like IEP meetings to go to, and I don't have a ton of coworkers to deal with every day. It's really just me and the family, and then me and another family, and then me and another family. And I really like that. I like the independence of it. So if you're considering earlier intervention, hey, I say do it, but make sure you have experience with a little one so you're prepared. You can watch my online course. It's for parents and therapists, and I'll take you through my step-by-step guide on how I work with toddlers, how I do earlier intervention. I think this could really help take the guesswork out of it for you. And actually, I know it will, because other speech therapists have been taking it and they've said it's been really helpful for them. They're like, okay, I know what to do. I feel great about this. So click the link below for my online course so that you also know what to do. I would love for you to have that resource. Connect with me on social media, Instagram and Facebook, so that we can be connected and you can see the daily activities that I'm doing there. I also have a free mini guide, 5 things every parent should know. And you could get this by signing up for the download, and you can print it and share it with your family so that they know the 5 things that every parent needs to know. Subscribe because I'm posting new videos weekly. Like, share, and comment. Thanks guys, and I'll see you in another video.
And now here's a testimonial from an SLP in Taiwan.
It's very inspirational.
So in the course, Kayla shared a lot of tools that she used, such as toys and songs and activities and even iPad. And they're all come with explanation on how and when and why to use them. So follow that rationale. You can come up with your own ideas on how to help your client. And most of the tools paired with demonstration clips. So in the clip, you can see the real interaction between Kayla and her client, so you can know how the tool is really used in therapy. So as I said, I really love the course.
Click the link in the description and use promo code 10YouTube for 10% off my online course. Also, if you're in California and you're a parent, I can totally do a phone consultation with you. There's a link below so that you can sign up for a consultation with me over the phone. If you're a therapist in the US, then we can do a consultation as well and talk about what's going on with your clients. Now, it's been great talking to you here. Please subscribe. And hey, check me out on social media, at Walkie Talkie Speech Therapy. On Instagram, I'm posting pretty much daily with lots of fun activities I'm doing with my kids. And follow me on Facebook, where you'll see more resources there. Guys, it's been great, and I can't wait to see you next time. Take care.